This week's Ask Dr. Duri is from a patient who wants to know about an ASH abstract. This patient had heard that there was an important abstract presented at this year's ASH held in San Diego in the first part of December, and that this abstract showed that double or two transplants in the early treatment of multiple myeloma was no longer recommended. And so the first answer to the question is that yes, indeed, there was such an abstract presented, and it did indeed indicate that there probably is not a routine need for double transplant in the frontline treatment of multiple myeloma. So this is a study called the STAMINA trial, and it was presented by Dr. Ed Stadmeier on behalf of the BMT-CTN group. And this study was a large one involving 758 patients who were distributed equally into three treatment arms. One group of patients received only one autologous stem cell transplant, ASCT. The second group received the same transplant, but in addition received four cycles of Velcade, Revlimid, and dexamethasone as a combination for what is called consolidation. And then the third group received double transplants, so that they received one, and then as soon as they were well recovered, they proceeded to receive that second or double transplant procedure. And so what I can say was really rather surprising to the investigators and certainly also to the doctors listening to this presentation was that all of the patients had the same outcome. The study was evaluated after 38 months, so approximately 3 years into the study. The length of the remissions were assessed and were equal. There was also assessment of how many patients had relapsed or progressed with the treatment, and again, these numbers were equal. Patients were evaluated based upon whether they had high-risk chromosomes or not, and also related to which centers that they received treatment. So a number of detailed aspects about the patients were considered. When the presentation was made, I would say that there was a lot of skepticism in the audience and many questions were raised, but ultimately, when the questions were answered, it seemed rather decisive that all of the outcomes were the same and that this was unlikely to change over time, even for patients with high-risk disease or patients who maybe have had a little bit deeper response with the double transplant possibly. It seemed like ultimately all the patients would end up having the same rather good benefit, but without one being better than the other. And so the really, really good news for patients is that double transplant and the consolidation are no longer routinely required. This is actually tremendous news because this is a lot of toxicity, a lot of time, a lot of added cost, a lot of disruption for work and the family, just a lot of implications. And if that really is not adding a substantial benefit, this is really, really tremendous news. And so I think that there is now a comfort level where doctors and patients can feel that there is no overwhelming reason to pursue this and go in that direction. There is a minor bottom line caveat that I would like to give, though, and that is that there has always been a suspicion that maybe some patients do need or benefit from that second transplant. And this may continue to be the case, and this is just not showing up in this large study. And so I do recommend that on an individual basis, patients should still talk about this with their doctor. And maybe if they've had a partial response with the first transplant, and maybe if they're in a high-risk group, it's still worthwhile to discuss the pros and cons with their doctor. But in the big, big picture, it seems that for the vast majority of patients, this rather arduous and difficult procedure, the tandem transplant, and also the consolidation can be set aside. So a very important presentation and a very positive outcome, I think, for patients, although this is what we would call a classic negative study.